These days, there are no restrictions on when people are choosing to retire. You hear people retiring as early as in their 20s, all the way to never retiring, even well into their 80s or 90s. In this video, I'm gonna go over what is the ideal age for you to retire in Canada. Hey, what's going on? It's Chris here from Wealth Awesome. According to a recent survey, 46% of Canadians expect to retire between the ages of 60 and 70, and 6% of Canadians expect that they will never retire. Stats Canada shows that the average retirement age of Canadians in 2020 was 64 years old. My parents have both retired recently exactly within this age range of between 60 and 70, and it seems that our society is set up for people to retire around this time. But more people than ever are choosing to buck the trend and retire either earlier or later in life. I'll go over several options from super early retirement in your 20s and 30s to never retiring. So make sure you stick around until after the list is finished, and I'll go over my personal thoughts about the best age to retire in Canada and what my hopeful plans are. If you get lost or want to learn more, you could check out the written article about this video on my website, wealthawesome.com. So first up, let's go over super early retirement. So between the ages of 30 and 49. There is a new movement called Financial Independence Retire Early, otherwise known as FIRE. Here, many people are choosing to adopt a very focused and ambitious goal of retiring very early in life, usually by saving an extreme portion of their salary and investing in the stock market or exchange-traded funds, or otherwise known as ETFs. Mr. Money Mustache, a former Canadian who has become an American, is probably the most famous example of this, and he's a guy that retired in his 30s and kind of kick-started this whole movement. He's got a really interesting story, so look him up. I found it really inspiring. This strategy requires a lot of discipline in your early years, with many starting to save in their 20s or even as teens aggressively. While there are many benefits of retiring early, there can be a lot of risks as well in planning for extremely early retirement. You'll have to consider the huge sacrifices you will need to make and how unpredictable life can be. There's a lot of things that can happen that would throw your calculations off. For example, if the markets don't go your way, or if your salary projections aren't correct, you might have to start working again or abandon this strategy altogether. And even after you retire, there are challenges too. You'll have to find meaning in your life that is outside of work and fill up your days. And a lot of people actually struggle with this. My view on FIRE is that no one ever really retires this early, and if you're ambitious enough to have this goal, you'll probably be working on projects and you'll never be fully retired. Next up, I'm gonna talk about so-called normal retirement, which is age 60 to 70. Most Canadians choose to retire in this age range, and it's easy to see why. You can start taking your Canada Pension Plan, or CPP, the earliest at age 60. But the longer you delay, the higher the payments you will receive. If you start your CPP at age 60, you'll receive 36% less than if you started at age 65. Though if you choose to start your CPP payments at age 70, you'll receive 42% more than if you started at age 65. Another thing that might kick in at this time is your old age security, or OAS. So that's if you're earning less than a certain amount. This could be a significant income source for many Canadians, so many have no choice but to wait until the ages 60 to 70 to retire. There's also the societal pressure to retire at this age. If most of your friends and colleagues are retiring in this age range, you might get lonely or bored if you decide to retire earlier or later. People might think you're kind of weird for wanting to retire earlier than this. Okay, next up is late retirement, so that's age 70 and older. According to Stats Canada, the number of Canadians retiring at 70 and older has more than doubled in the last 10 years, which is a very significant increase. And here are some of the reasons more Canadians are choosing to retire later in life. Number one is that there's no more mandatory retirement age of 65. In 2009, the government decided to get rid of this restriction, giving Canadians a choice to continue to work as long as they wanted to. Number two is that people are living longer and are healthier. With advancements in healthcare and the overall well-being of Canadians, we're living longer than ever. This means that more money will be needed in retirement, so more people are choosing to work longer. two out of five Canadians who are 65 will live past the age of 90, which is a very long time to be retired if you retire in your 60s. Some people enjoy their work. I know this sounds crazy, but yes, many people either get bored during retirement or are really passionate about their job. Because of this, they decide to continue working instead of retiring. Some people fear that they will run out of money. Probably the most obvious one here is that you'll earn more money when you work more. You'll also maximize your retirement income payouts, such as your CPP and OAS. The fear of running out of money keeps many people working past the age of 70. Another option is early retirement. So that's between the ages of 50 to 64. Many Canadians dream about retiring early as they start to get burned out from their work in their 40s and 50s. I'm sure that most people would probably choose to retire early if they had the means. Requires a lot of discipline as well as being able to make a lot of money or save a high percentage of your money each year and investing it wisely. While it's easy to see the benefits of early retirement, such as more free time, less stress, and the ability to travel, there's also downsides to early retirement that I touched on before. You might feel more stressed if you didn't save enough money and are constantly worrying about not having enough money to last. There's also the chance, as I said, you could get bored and lonely if nobody else you know is retired. That can harm your health. If early retirement is your goal, think it through carefully and make sure you have planned out your finances and your life after retirement very carefully. All right, so here's my thoughts about retiring and what age I want to retire in. Before, I was pretty into the FIRE movement. I did a lot of research into it and I wanted to see what was the feasible option of retiring before the ages of 40. While I do think it's a noble goal, I don't think it's the correct one in the sense that it stresses retiring early over anything else. For me, I think it's more important to find something you're passionate about doing. And in that way, it doesn't really matter what age you retire, because if you enjoy what you do, you'll want to keep on doing it. This is something that is very dear to me because I've struggled a lot with finding my career path. I've tried a lot of different jobs. If you follow my blog or this YouTube channel, you know I talk a lot about my career struggles and just finding something that I really like doing. And now that I finally found what I'm doing, I don't really care when I retire. I can see myself doing this for 20, 30 years and I'll be perfectly happy. It's something I really enjoy doing. Obviously, not everyone is in that position, so maybe if you're not able to find what you love doing, having this early retirement goal is a great option. I also think that retiring too late is not that good. Obviously, for health-wise and spending time with your family, it's important to find things outside of work that satisfy what your life goals are. So overall, I think that it's really unique to your situation. For me, I just want to keep on doing what I love, putting out this content and making people more knowledgeable and spreading my knowledge. It really gives me a lot of satisfaction to do that. So a big way that I've been able to manage my finances is with EQ Bank. They've been a real game changer for me and they offer a pretty high interest rate. Right now it's 1.25%, which is way higher than anything that the big banks offer. So if you're able to save some money and you need some emergency savings, or you want to earn more interest than what the big banks are offering, check out EQ Bank. I put a description in the link below. So all in all, there's no right answer as to what is the best age to retire in Canada. It's such a personal decision, and sometimes it's not even the choice of when you retire. You can get forced out by your company, or you might need the money so you can't retire until later. Sometimes it's not a choice for a lot of people. And the most important thing though is finding the balance and making the decision that will ultimately make you the happiest. Maybe you enjoy your work with your colleagues and want to continue past your 60s. Or maybe you want to retire early because you value your time with your grandchildren or spouse, or want to travel in an RV across the continent, or you want to country hop across Europe and Asia. Whatever age you plan on retiring, try to time it the best that you can for your happiness. All right, so since you made it this far, make sure you like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on future tips. Also, be sure to check out the blog, wealthawesome.com. It's one of Canada's leading personal finance blogs. It goes into this topic in way more detail and also has many other topics for Canadians to look at that aren't just retirement related. I have a lot of investing and making money advice as well. So make sure you check it out. And as always, thanks for listening.